Alright? The raiders! The raiders are here! The raiders are here! Women, we have to leave now! The raiders are here! The raiders are here!
Beautiful morning. Sunny, fine day out here. The planting season is almost here. And I'm gonna need some hefty men to work on my farm. Oh, fella. How are you? Very good, thank you. Oh, by the way, the last time we did my business together, you sold me some very, very fine slaves. That's why I've come back. It looks like you've got some very well-built slaves here. Old man, can you step out here? Thank you. You want to be quick? This old man is not going to be of any use. He's hunched over, dentists are very terrible, no muzzle, he hasn't got anything, and you fall back. Thank you. All right, I see. Okay, I see. Can you step out? Quickly, I haven't got this much time. Quickly. Well, this looks very well fed. Very good flesh. She should be good hands in the kitchen. Don't worry, by the time you get to know me, you will love me. Can you stand there? Thank you. Can you stand there? Quick. And you, come out here. Such very young, small people become very useful when we train them. But this doesn't look like he's got any promise. How do you train these very thin muscles and flat ones? Young man, thank you. Can you go back? Thank you. Yes, can you come out here? Quickly. My time is running out. Oh my goodness! Fella! Wow! Ajayi's men! This must be the best buy of the day! Very good chest! It looks like it's gonna grow to be very hefty and useful! No, I'm not doing anything to you! You are gonna walk on my fire! Alright? Can you jump a bit? Let's see if you've got some strength! Okay? Alright, very nice. Beautiful day. Step out there. Thank you. Yeah, thank you, man. Thank you. See you. Can you step out? Quick! Can you step out?
step out! Quick!
Thank you.
Samuel, I have just received this letter this morning from the committee of the CMS in England. It says that the Queen has authorised an exploration of the Niger River. This mission is an opportunity for us to go into new territories and to reach out to those who have never heard about the Lord Jesus. The letter also has authorised you, Mr. Simon Carver, and myself, the excellent Reverend James, to join this expedition and to bring the blessings of the gospel to the poor people who are in darkness, so that God's light may also shine on them also.
That's very interesting. You know, there's nothing that will give me greater pleasure than to do God's bidding. I know it's going to be an interesting journey. And when we're going to Africa and around my home, it will probably give me the opportunity to find my people, find my family.
Okay.
If you allow me, Lord Jesus, I'd like to take my leave so that I can prepare for the journey.
Please.
Thank you very much. Glory to God, who makes a way through the mighty waters, that the gospel may be preached to the farthest part of the earth.
I know that it is God's will for us to engage. I also know that God will strengthen us and remove every obstacle that's in our way. Therefore, I take great pleasure in his precious promise. Amen.
As we were hoping you will welcome the new visitor, Chief, Ajayi is in town. Ajayi.
Well, welcome to the palace, Ajayi.
Yes, Ajayi.
What took you so long to come, Ajayi? We have been expecting you for the past 20 months.
Yeah.
That was when she tripped over to the life. Or is it because you came at that rate? It's better than our village. Speak up, Ajayi.
It was never my intention to not come to you. We were detained in Badagry.
Detained in Badagry?
We weren't allowed to leave. We only saw an opportunity when acting the slave trader sent a gift of £200 to you, requesting your slaves.
Detained? That's not acceptable, Badagry.
No, I'm accepting.
You mean you were taken from your family to be sold as slave?
No, Your Majesty. Not to be sold as slaves. But even though we were detained, we were allowed to move freely amongst the people. And that gave us the opportunity to preach the good news to the people of Badagry. And also, it gave us the opportunity to change the good book and translate it from that of the foreign language to our native tongue, so our people would be able to interpret it, read, and understand.
Good news. Quiet, woman! This is the palace of Chiptagua.
Sorry.
Women are not allowed to talk. Keep your sorry! Ah!
I'm sorry, Chief.
You are supposed to be sitting here and not heard.
Yes.
Sorry, my Chief.
Apologies, Chief.
That is the picture of God. You mean you were able to translate the books from the language of the foreigners into our native language?
Your Majesty,
tell me about this good book, Ajayi. I was told that it's a big God in this book before whom one man are born equal. How can one man be born equal, Ajayi?
Well, Chief, he is a God, and we will all stand before him, and before him, we are all equal. There is no slave, there is no master.
Ajayi, Ajayi, Ajayi. Is it that your travel around the world has turned your mind around? How come you sit here and claim that everyone is equal to Chief Chagwa on the throne?
I don't mean to undermine your authority here.
You better not be.
But the Lord's authority is greater. And I tell you, we're all equal. What's left to say?
All right, okay. You don't mean to say all of us are slaves. There are some of us that do not flow in our veins.
Yes, yes.
I'd like to think so, but we all have red blood flowing through our veins. You know, the mercy of God, in His mercy, He sent His Son to deliver us from sin.
Ajayi, you have come again. You have a new God. And your God even has a son. You are a jester. Ajayi, you like to jest. His God has a son.
But I tell you, Chief, I warn you, I tell you, He is a merciful God. And He sent His only Son to come and to live among us indeed. First, hunger like we do.
Man, never have I heard a God that have ever come in form of a man. You mean if I send one of my warriors to cut him with a knife and blade?
Chief, I tell you what, he bled.
Ajayi, you make me laugh. I'm having a good laugh. Ajayi. Ajayi, you have a God that has his own. And in fact, your God even bleeds. What God bleeds? Ajayi.
Again, your gesture.
Panileri.
Like it's a lightly matter. But He came and He died for our sins. He died. He was whipped on His way to the cross that we may be delivered from all manner of sickness and diseases. That we may be free from the shackles of sin, no longer slaves to sin.
Ajayi, wait right there. Did I hear you say your God can heal sicknesses?
Oh yes, He can.
We have got the first job for your God then. By the way, do you know that Chief's wife has been sick and bedridden for many moons now?
On my arrival, sir, I heard the news. I'm very aware. And I can tell you boldly that my God can heal her. If you will lead the way, Chief, I will follow you so I can pray with your wife. And you will see what the mighty God will do. I am not here to prove Him. He will prove Himself.
That must be mighty God, Chief.
Never have I heard that God is powerful. You mean your God can heal my wife?
Oh yes, He can.
Tell me, Andrew! How much is it going to cost me out of my kingdom?
No, Chief. It's not going to cost you a single penny. But lead the way, and I will pray for you.
That must be some kind of God who doesn't take anything. He's everything free.
Yes! Go ahead and get my wife ready!
Carol, Baba.
Thank you.
I never knew what a chief's wife is now available, has he? We just came up for what he's done.
Thank God.
I'm sure this will prove to the society that there is a real God.
Of course. Yes. God will do great and mighty things in addition to that.
Jay, there's a lady coming towards us.
Mama! Oh my God! I come in! Chief.
Thank you, Chief. You know, I can take the glory for his God who sent me to do his bidding.
My good people of Abiyokuta, what a guy can't wait to do news. And I want to encourage you all to listen to him. Once again, thank you again.
You're welcome, sir.
As you can see, my wife is here with me.
Oh, I can see she's looking so radiant. Indeed, the Lord has done a good work. How do you feel, ma'am?
Ajayi, wait there, wait. The people of Abiyokuta, you all are witnesses to the long-term illness of Chief's wife. And to double that, you are witnessing the new radiance of a beautiful wife of the Chief. Ajayi has got a new job. You want to listen. Ajayi, you have the floor.
As I was saying before Chief came in, all we need to do is to give our lives to this God and He will transform us. You know, the freedom that we enjoy in God is not to do what we like, but to do what we ought. And if we do not know Him, how then are we to know what to do? So if you want to give your life to this God for Him to transform your life, just signify by raising your hands.
Moshe Tom, I am ready. I am ready to take your gods.